All right, welcome back, and immediately into Fast Forward.
It's the hard knock life for us. It's the hard knock life for us. Stand and treat it, we get tricked. Stand and keep says, we get picked. It's the hard knock life.
Okay, I think we'll pick up back from here. I'm right near Reuben, but I'm not actually going to stop in. This time I need to find something I can eat first. I've been to a couple of shops on the way, not had much luck there. I bought some vegetables off one of the guardsmen, and that kept my hunger from getting too ridiculous, but I still need to get it down, I think. Also, my infection's starting to creep up, which is obviously also not a good thing, but I believe this whole area we're heading into now should be clear based on what Notkin said. So yeah, we're gonna head into the area, we're going to rough up some ruffians, get their crowbars for Notkin, and we're going to have a word with Sticky while we're up there as well, because he seems like a good boy. He doesn't deserve all the drama that's happening. I can't remember, did we actually get a quest to talk to Sticky last time? I should really check these things before I just start recording, but, you know, it wouldn't be me otherwise, would it? Yeah, this guy actually has some food for sale, and it's not that expensive. Is there any chance I can maybe, with a sale of a lockpick, that'll get me a little bit in the right direction? Or am I better off just using the lockpicks and stealing food from people, you know? Is that going to be the better option here? I can get to 900, which, I don't know, I feel like I'm close. Sell one of them, buy some food. That seems like a sensible move, and then maybe, yeah, we'll use the lockpicks to grab a few little extra bits and bobs while we're in this region up here. Plus, you know, anything we find in the bins, also helpful. I don't really have a house in mind in particular that I wanna start digging through, but I don't know, I guess I'll play it by vibes, right? I think we can break into basically any of these houses. There's only specific buildings we're not allowed to break into, so I can just feel like I'm in the mood for it. Okay, I don't know if this guy's going to be hostile. I don't know who's going to be hostile around here, so let's just save and be smart about this. Okay, cool. I don't think this was actually it was like this top region, wasn't it? You do have a quest to see Sticky. Don't know where I got that from, but whatever. Yeah, it's the top section that was actually plagued before, so I assume that's the section that these bad men are going to be hanging out in. Assuming I can get around there. I'm being thoroughly defeated by fencing right now. You know how it is. You look like a ruffian. You look like a foul fellow. I don't think you actually are, but you look like one. Okay, they've still got the plague banners up and the guardsmen hanging out. Is it good up here now? I don't see all the bloody rags on the floor or the spooky ghost men. I mean, if the guardsmen are about, I can definitely use them to my advantage as well, if there are people I need to fight up here. So that's all good. That's all positive. I'm not seeing any... I don't know if we actually need to, like, go into the buildings, because I said something about them looting the buildings. I can hear babies screaming, and that's not a happy vibe. Is this not Sticky's house? Is it the other side we have to go in through? Is that the problem? It's only got one open door? Yeah, okay. You're Sticky, I forget why I'm coming to see you, but I am coming to see you, I'll tell you that much.
My knee pits itch.
And that's just dirty. It's all in the halves, those pricks. Say I lick Khan's boots. Call me a traitor. Now they won't take me with them to mug the barbers, those stinkers. Not barbers. Hello there, living under a rock or what? The angry guys that split off from Grief's gang to cut people on the streets. We ain't listening to you no more, they said. The kin's gone, the old life's blasted, so we ain't got nothing to lose. Big words, sir. So they went to slashing and robbing everyone, those sons of bitches. And so your friends are planning to attack them? This kid is like 6, by the way. He's not even just like a 12-year-old who could potentially be getting into this shit. He is like a child. So your friends are planning to attack them? They ain't no friends of mine. Arrogant bastards, stinky turncoats. Oh, I hate them. What do I do to them? That's not an answer. Well, yeah, they are. And if they, as if they'd have a shot at it, they planned on arming up, got them weapons stored at a certain place. Well, I'm going to ruin their party. How about we snatch their weapons away? And we'll save the dumbheads from the barber's knives as well. Why not? Where is this place? Go to the cemetery. You'll find a buddy of mine there named Stump. Tell him we're in cahoots and all that. He'll take you to the place. Rubberneck is the word. You got to share, though. If you don't share with me, there'll be payback. Rubberneck it is. Deal. Alright, could get some potential more powerful weaponry, and that means I could potentially sell off my my existing gun and make a little bit of cash on that. So, where are these barbers, though? That's what they were called. I was just calling them ruffians because I couldn't remember their names. The barbers are the ones we're after. They're meant to be around here. They don't mean the guards, do they? I really don't want to fight a guard. You were... There you go, have some water. You want a barter? Okay, this guy's... Okay, he's got nothing. But these are the sort of lads we can trade water with. That's interesting. That's potentially useful. Hello. He has vegetables. I can't afford it. I seem to remember saying there's other options to one of these guys before and it resulting in them attacking me. So I was trying to just pick an option to escape from that conversation, but there didn't really seem to be one. Who are these barbers? Am I missing something? Am I not understanding? Wasn't expecting to just be able to go into this building. In case you're wondering what happened there, the game minimized itself. Apparently it really didn't want me doing what I just did. So whoopsie, I guess. Did I save after speaking to Stakey, or are we going to have to redo that? Yeah, I assume those are the barbers. We need to fuck those guys up, get the crowbars. I guess all the houses are just unlocked. I guess that's the deal, and we go in them to... This was when I first entered this part of town, wasn't it? Okay. It's okay. We know what we're doing now. We'll head up to Sticky, but I'll just, like, pop into buildings on the way. And, you know, potential loot for me in the process, so... I assume it has to be in the previously infected area. Which begins just up here. Not these buildings. These ones are all... high society fellas. No drama to be had in... Oh, hello. Hello there. This was unexpected. Not unwanted, mind you. I kind of wanted to let him kill one of the guardsmen because they might have some good loot, but at the same time, I just... Oh, he didn't have any fucking razors. What the fuck, man? Never thought I'd be in such... high demand for razors, but here we are. Okay, real quick save. Real quick. Hello. Oh yeah, you be stuck there. Wow, this guy's so fucking nimble. I cannot hit these fuckers without taking a hit back. That changes things a lot. That really does. There's no easy victory here. I can't just kite them like I've been kiting other people. They got like some serious martial arts skills. Hey, you just be stuck there a second. Hang on. Quite costly when it comes to bullets, but I mean, I get quite a bit of cash from these fuckers. Well, not a lot really, but a bit. A little bit of something for me. There's gonna be more than one. Yeah, yes, yes there is. What the fuck? What button did I just press? How did I do that? Did not mean to unequip my... I literally fucking jumped. That was the biggest fucking jump scare in the world. I don't want to die, but I'm gonna die. Shh. You can call me a safe scummer all you like, alright? Sometimes needs must. This game is absolutely one that you're 100% expected to safe scum your way through. It's way too punishing for any other options. I'd love to see someone play through this game blind for the first time. What the fuck? Don't take two shots. Is that all my bullets? Right, okay, I still have... Wait, no, I don't. That's revolver ammo. Yeah, that was all my bullets. Shit. got more rewards from him this time, at least. Well, that's a problem, isn't it? Alright, back to the knife, then. How many crowbars did he say he needed? Five? Was it five he wanted? I literally can't hit him. Like, half the time my attacks just aren't making contact. I don't understand. I mean, it's probably because I'm backing in and out of combat trying to avoid their attacks, but... Because they're in buildings like this, I can't even try and kite them. It's really annoying. Right, you need to die in one hit. I am begging you to die in one hit. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I don't know if we can try and kite. Fuck, missed. How did I change weapons last time? How did I do it? Because I did. I did do it. Yep. Can't do it in combat. Cannot change weapons in combat for the life of me. I don't know how to overcome this. I don't know how to beat these guys. It's only because this guy gets stuck on a wall that I can even take him out. Or her out. Is it a her? I don't know. They're quite small and wiry, so I think it's women, but they don't really have like a female body shape. Sure you don't want to get stuck where your friend did? Ah, shit. Okay. There's got to be a hotkey for changing... Well, I know there's a hotkey for changing weapon because I literally did it. Let's find that out. Let's see if we can understand what I pressed last time to switch to my fists. I'd rather switch to a knife, like, but... Better than nothing, I suppose. If I do this tab, shift is crouch. I don't really know what that activated sticky keys. Control does nothing. Ah, X to quick swap to the fists. Okay. I'd rather quick swap to the knife, but I don't think that's an option. Look at all the money that time. This is the true way to make money. Just repeatedly reload until you can get the absolute maximum amount of cash from a lad. Hey, okay. That was the way to do it. Don't panic. Just trade a punch to the face for a shot to the head. Okay. Doesn't mean we're in the clear yet, but I am going to save. Gonna call that a minor victory. Any more up here? Any more of these fuckers? Nothing to loot, it doesn't look like, annoyingly. Huh? I stand corrected. Kerosene. Yeah, I'll take some kerosene. It's used for refilling the lamp. Well, it's used for selling, is what it's used for. Come on, just have some bread lying out on the side somewhere. You know you want to. Nothing in this little bowl. I'll take these handful of coins, but I'm much more interested in finding food, if I'm honest with you. Nothing? Nothing. What the fuck would you have a picture of a dead body just hanging, like, directly opposite your bed? That's what you're looking at as you're drifting off to sleep. Just someone, like, mauled and dragged across a floor. Yeah, that's normal behaviour, isn't it? That's the thing normal people do. Didn't necessarily give the most thorough of searches down here before, so I'm just gonna double check there's nothing else I missed. That's lootable. Didn't think it was. Those are like a billion doors. But I assume none of them actually work. Or just fake. Fake doors. Okay. Another quick save. This is my life now. Yeah, I'm assuming the reason they're in the buildings is so you can't abuse these guys as an extra little... I thought maybe we could trade crowbars. Crowbars. They're only worth two, though. I was kind of hoping they'd be worth a bit more than that. Shit. Okay. I need bullets, is what I need. Is that a stabby man? Is that a stabby man or a drunk man? Yo, do you have a knife? Yo. Yo. Pay attention to me. Yo. Yeah, you got a knife. Come. I was trying to zigzag. I was doing my best. That guy's got a good throwing arm on him. I'll give him that. I just don't want to fight him myself, man. I just want to lure him back to the guards. I'd really like to get one to kill a guard for me. I think that could potentially be very beneficial. Oh, hey, he's a bit closer this time. That works out. Come on, spot me from miles away. Yeah, there we go. That's what I was trying to get to happen. Hey, yo, dudes. Dudes, there's a bad man. There's a bad man, dudes. Get him. Okay, he's not going to kill a guard because he's hyper-focused on me, but I can get the guards to kill him at least. Get him! Oh fuck. Oh well, that worked. Wasn't perhaps the most optimal pathing, but... Still no razors either, goddammit. Getting low on the old health. Don't have anything I can use to get it back up. I use my two tourniquets on recovering the health I lost with popping my immunity tablets. This? Nothing there. You? No? I don't know. I don't know why we got a little symbol pop up there. I don't know what was new. Nothing, I don't think. This is sticky. Hello again, young sir. Your mind's been erased, but we have had a conversation already. Let's have another one. What?
How does one protect himself from
Okay, there we go. I'm sure I said the same things as last time, and the conversation went a different way, but I don't know, maybe I'm just being dumb. Okay, I might... Oh, I've not got room for him. Shit. I'm going to say I might try and trade for the trade some water with the drunks, but clearly not working. Don't think have I been in this food shop? Have I been in here? Oh shit, this isn't a food shop. I mean, it is. It definitely is. So, I mean, if I can clear this one out, maybe there'll be food in the offing. I don't think I'm going to be able to, but god damn it, I will try. Not ideal, is it? But you see what I mean, though? I mean, I was stood right in front of the guy, swinging my dagger, and, like, no blood came off, so I assume I wasn't hitting, but I don't really get why I wasn't hitting. Is there, like, some... Is it not just, like, you know, FPS mechanics where if it hits, it hits? Is there some, like, RPG dice rolling behind the scenes and, like, I'm failing my hit rolls or whatever? Jesus Christ, that was immediate. That was instant. The second they came in contact with me, I was over. I was done. My goose had been proverbially cooked. I need to kill 3 more of these fuckers. I need some healing, man. Thing is, the health shops, the pharmacies, whatever you want to call them, the drug stores, they only seem to sell, like, medicine. They don't seem to sell tourniquets anymore. Fuck. That wasn't great timing. Yeah, I cannot win that. I cannot overcome that. We need to find some other options right now. And knife fighting just isn't a thing, I don't think. Like, even with the easy, quote-unquote easy knife fights from the beginning of the game against the knife men in the streets or whatever, even those, they took like a billion hits, and if you actually just tried to trade blows with them, they would destroy you. And these guys are just way beyond anything I can deal with. I'm gonna have to get that infection down as well. I can't afford to keep dealing with all this. Where is a medicine place? It's gotta be one of these two buildings. I think one of them's a clothes shop, but the other one is presumably medicine. Presumably. That might be a wild claim. I need to recover some health because I can't take a hit at the moment. And until I can, I'm not gonna be getting anything done. You just don't get enough money for kills to, like, recuperate your health, you know what I mean? It's just... I mean, obviously, it's all in the name of realism, and I understand it, but, like, as far as, like, understandable game mechanics, like, the sort of thing that, like... I mean, I'm going to go back to World of Warcraft here, because it's an obvious sort of comparison, in that that is, like, a big open-world RPG-ish thing, and also from, like, a massive company that sort of has established rules and things. This guy is selling tourniquets, thank fuck. Not that I can afford any, but, you know... the kerosene doesn't even sell for very much. That's really upsetting. But yeah, in that game, like, food costs you nothing, right? Food's basically free. If you're a mage, it is free. So playing that and then playing this game that, like, punishes you for trying to fight is a pretty wild comparison. Does not slow down the rate of infection. Increases immunity. I think maybe, yeah, these are the ones that do drop my infection meter. But I can't afford those. And organs don't sell for shit, do they? No. Literally zero. Do I have to sell my gloves? I mean, I can sell this revolver ammo. I'm not fucking using that, am I? I need to... You know what? Fuck the lockpicks. We need some of these. We bought a tourniquet. Let's get a second one. Oh boy. Oh boy, times are getting rough, I'll tell you that. I probably should have just sold the gun as well, if I'm honest with you. Okay. Okay. That's fine. That's fine. My health took a hit, but I recouped most of it. Right, we're gonna have to go and pick up Sticky's gun, I think. He said it was by the cemetery, right? Is it marked on my map? It's not. Sticky still is. By the cemetery, one of the homeless children will meet anyone brave enough to enter the house where the weapons are hidden. Okay, we'll just head to the cemetery. None of our bars are at such a point right now that it's going to be a major issue in the immediate future. So, yeah, we've got time to go to the cemetery. And if we can get a new gun, I mean, the gun isn't the thing really, is it? It's the ammo that we need, but a new gun will be a step in the right direction at least. I mean, the old gun was good, you know? The old gun got the job done. There's one shot in those bad boys, right? But just keeping ammunition for it has proven incredibly difficult. Hey you, do you sell ammunition? You do. What for? Absolutely nothing I carry. Okay, cool. Is that just for money she was trading for? I don't know, but nothing I had was lighting up, so. Where am I? I've lost myself on the map. There I am. Okay. Oh man, it's too hot at the moment. This is just me every video, by the way. For anyone who's not witnessed Joe in the summer prior to this, this is just how I am. Between like June and September, it's just too hot, man. It's too hot. It's not even supposed to be that bad today. There's like quite heavy fog and stuff, so like, you know, the air is quite wet at least, if not necessarily cool. But I'm still absolutely sitting here sweating like a little pig. It's disgusting. Keep making the mistake of buying leather chairs. And I should just get, to be fair, no, I have had a canvas computer chair before. While I didn't stick to it in the summer, I did just fill it with sweat and it just got nasty as fuck. So you just can't really win with computer chairs, I don't think. They're just always going to get grim in the summer. What do you want, eh? Got yourself a death wish? Are you stump? Busybody is the word. I'll be the one to escort you instead of Sticky. Ah, well done, Sticky, because, you know, people say it's dangerous out there. These jerks have gone absolutely mental. They're running rampant. I'll put a knife or two into them if I could too. Oh, come on, follow me. Wait a bit. We run, no stops. Time is short. Hopefully we won't run into them on our way. You'll probably fight back well enough though. Let's go. I hope he can fight back as well, because I'm going to let him go ahead so he can draw aggro. And then I'll do the thing where I just, you know, stab the dude while they're otherwise engaged. Oh look. Oh look, a suspicious man with a knife. Is this this is underneath the what's-her-face's house, isn't it? That cellar that I kept going into and going, what's the point of this? Oh shit, he's coming for me. Fuck. Oh no, there's two of them. Oh, what? I'm not gonna fight back. I think I've decided I'm not gonna fight back. I'm just gonna keep following the child. It's gonna be difficult because he moves quite a bit slower than me. Yeah, is this the place? Uh-oh. Did I save? Please tell me I saved. That thumbnail looked pretty yellow. Looked pretty much like a man from a more diseased corner of the map is what that looked like. Joe, my dude. Well, am I not learning my lesson yet? Okay. Well, once more with feeling, I suppose. We'll do the... You know what? We'll fast forward this bit as well. Okay. So you may have noticed that my health is criminally low right now. The shop I went to, the same drugstore, whatever you want to call it, health shop that I went to before I loaded, wasn't selling tourniquets this time. So instead, I just bought the infection fixing tablets, and my health is like this now. So really, the only option I have right now with these two fuckers is to try to lure them either to somewhere where they stop aggroing me. There's more! Yo, you're coming too. Yo, get on me. Hope that dagger missed. It seems to have. I'm not dead. We're gonna have to lure them to somewhere where the guards can deal with them, I think, is the only real option we've got now, right now. What's this little fucking ring here? They said something about pit fighting at one point. Is this where that takes place? I didn't really clock that before. I have been up here before, but it was right at the start of the game, and it's before I really knew anything about anything. I still feel like I don't know anything about this game, even now. There's still a lot of stuff I'm just not getting. Also, you note my health is ticking down as well. That's the other problem. I assume it's because my infection rate is like over half or around half. That's enough for it to... Oh fuck, there's more of them. They're already engaged. My dudes, I need help here. I'm a worried citizen. I need support from the good men of the police department. Fuck. I don't know if the good men of the police department are providing any assistance right now. Oh fuck. Wait, hold up. So the question is, what's happened to the kid? Oh god, look at my health. Holy shit, look at my health. I'm just gonna die. I'm just gonna fucking die. There we go, that gave me a tiny bit back. I know it's considerably more effective when you're asleep, but it bought me some time. I should have thought of just going into a building sooner, really. I don't know if it's going to work, though. I guess we'll find out, won't we? See if the lad's still standing there. He's around the back of this building. Do I just, like... It's going to put my hunger up. I might just... She's got a bed, right? There's a bed in here. Is this a bed? Can I sleep on this? Yeah. Just sleep for like 2 hours. Oh, the medicine didn't do anything.
What's wrong with my eyes?
I don't know. What's wrong with my eyes? Fuck it. Go again. Where's the drugs? Sleep more. Okay, well, my health still ain't great and my hunger is skyrocketing, but the only real option I had, if I'm honest... Oh, it's raining. Isn't that nice? A cover of moisture. This was the right place, right? The kid's just fucking gone. He's left me. I assume he's reset, and if we talk to him again, It's just going to respawn the bad guys. So much for my cheese strategy. Or maybe he's just not even fucking there anymore. Maybe that's also a possibility. Shit, I was kind of hinging a lot on getting this new gun. I'm not going to lie to you. I was kind of reliant on it. Was it here? Was it here he was bringing me? Let's just real quick. No. Okay. Alright. Might have been over here, actually. I think it was over here. Oh, I sold my lockpicks. Fuck. This redo of day 4. Not been as productive as I kind of wish it had been. You know what I mean? I feel like maybe it could have gone a little bit better. If anything, I would say it went worse than my original day 4. Because I've started a bunch of shit, succeeded in none of it, and used up all my supplies in the process. This rain is adequately reflecting my mood right now. This perfectly encapsulates how I'm feeling at present. Gonna have to get some food. Fuck. Checking all the bins as if I'm gonna find anything that's gonna completely change my life and my way of thinking. If I can just get some food, right? Where's the food place from here? I feel like it's one of these. I can't remember. I think this up here is a food place, right? Yeah. I can get some food, just get my hunger meter to a semi-acceptable level. And then I'm just going to have to commit to moving on to day 5. I do have a bit of money, thankfully. Vegetables. Cracker. Cracker. Oh, he only has one cracker. Vegetables. Cracker. Yeah. 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 I dropped the vegetables. Doesn't this just sum it all up? God, that was nothing. That was all my money, and look how much it helped. It didn't, basically. It didn't help. It didn't help at all. But fuck it. Let's go see the man who wants me dead. Progress on to day 5. This isn't how I do that. This isn't how I do that at all. This is walking into a dead end in the pouring rain. Oh, woe is me. Woe is me and my suffering. The Pathologic really does seem to be the sort of game where you can just fuck yourself. And I think I might be getting to the point where I've done that. Like, I didn't play optimally in the first few days, and as a result, this day and the next day are just getting increasingly more difficult. Clearly should have put more effort, in retrospect, put more effort into getting a gun and plenty of ammunition for it, so I could have an easier time of the challenges ahead. Obviously, I was smart to not use ammunition in those early nights. I should have focus more on just doing as much murder as possible in those early nights, getting rid of all the knife men, collecting all their razors, which I could now be trading for food and things at this point, collecting their organs and stuff. Thing is, I don't have any fucking twire. I don't have any twire, and I don't really have any way of getting any twire. So I can't even, like, put all these organs I'm collecting to use. You know what I mean? Because the little bit of blood I've collected is not worth shit. The worms will give me, like, a herb for the entire quantity of blood in the entire city's populace. You know what I mean? Roll in there with a massive like tankard of blood, and they're like, well, I'll trade you this leaf for it and we'll call it a good deal. And look, I've already got a bunch of fucking organs in here. We'll deposit all these. I guess I'll hold on to the blood. Get rid of all these. Try and trade the blood with the... with the children of Bodo themselves. There's no point doing that right now, though. We'll just move on. We'll get imprisoned. Again, this feels like a really dumb thing to do when my health is this low and my hunger is this high, but I don't really have the means to do anything about either of those issues, so we're just going to have to commit. We're just going to have to commit to this. I don't have many other options available to me anymore. Ah, fuck, man. Hello. I don't suppose you've got like any food just like hanging out in the back of your house, do you? Nothing I can loot back here. No, that'd be far too convenient. Fair enough. Have a nice day.
Perfect valor.
Ba 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 ba. Clicky clicky clicky. Okay. I'm gonna have to save. We're gonna have to commit right now. Oh, I really thought there might be something in that chest. I was really hoping against hope. Come on then, arrest me. Really didn't take that much punching, mate. Really didn't. Wait, what? Why did I just die? Hold on. Hold on, that's not how this is meant to go. Why did I just fucking die? Was I not meant to have been arrested? Is that not how this is meant to go? It's because they all hit me. They all hit me and it killed me. Whereas if you take one hit... Oh, that's stupid. Stop, I need... Performance is being rehearsed at the theater. I need to loot this fucker. Give... The fact that there's just gas constantly leaking in here is such bullshit. It really is. Come on, you fuckers. Come out and get me. Where are yous? More gas coming. Let's get that immunity up. More immunity, please. Thank you. My health is fucked, but at least I have immunity. Hello. Excuse me. Did I not just blow a chunk of that dude's head off? Why is he just walking away? This is the some like next level bullshit. This really is. Yo, dude. Can I not shoot through these bars? Yes, I can. But now, I have another problem. Alright, one more time. So bullets don't go very far, turns out I need to wait till they're pressed up against the bars, and I need to point my gun out and literally have it attached to their temple. One hit, there we go. This actually heals me, which is pretty nice, I think. I actually get a little bit of recovery from this.
The day is over. Your timely efforts allowed your supporters to remain unharmed. A new mime performance is being rehearsed at the theatre.
Right, gun. Because this fucking text was up. I didn't get to do my speed run correctly. How much of this gas is coming at me? That's my immunity fucked. Okay. Right. Anytime anyone other than a big cloud of death gas wants to come over here, that would be fucking great. Got him. What the fuck? Was he in the cell with me? What just happened? What actually just happened? As soon as I pulled the trigger, the guy was already punching me in the side of the fucking brain. Right, this time we're doing it. This time we're succeeding. I'm telling you. I'm promising you.
The day is
to get to the right angle to loot this fucker.
Your supporters to remain unharmed. A new mime performance is being rehearsed.
There we go. Can't shoot these guys till the text goes away, so I just have to sort of accept my fate with these two big clouds of gas. In which the Harris Pex gets a chance to grab Her Highness the Elusive Sand Plague by the tail. That's something to look forward to, isn't it? Please stop. Please stop. It's not funny. Pathologic, it's not funny what you're doing to me right now. Right. Oh, fuck. Because I'm always like blurry faced from the fucking from the plague, I can't actually like get a decent shot on these dudes as they sprint in at 9,000 miles an hour like an out of control steam train and just crash into my body, deleting me from existence with the slightest tender caress of their fists. It's absolutely batshit insane what they're putting on my plate, and it like they set this up perfectly, right? The game designers know exactly what's happening here. Because my bars get set to levels that were nothing to do with what my levels were before, right? The health, hunger, infection, reputation, all that has been set to levels that they've picked. As I sit here now, I can't do anything right now. I can't actually loot this guy. I just have to be at the exact right pixel. But the point is, I get gas twice, which drops my immunity to that exact level. Meaning I then have to hightail it into chugging all these drugs, equipping my gun, and then the dude comes back as I'm suffering from the effects of this cloud, right? And then another cloud hits me. Oh no, it actually doesn't. That's a lie. I'm still... Fuck. Oh man. But it's like such a pristine sequence of events is what I'm trying to say here. You know what I mean? You have to pull it all off perfectly. Perfectly. And not have that happen where you get caught between a dude and a fence, and then they just punch you to death before you can even get arrested. As I say, like I've been saying this since the start with this game, I really want to like it. I really, really want to like it. There's so much promise, so much creativity involved, so much thinking outside the box with regard to game development that you just don't see with AAA games, you know? But god fucking damn, does it make it difficult. This game goes out of its way to make you hate it. And I guess that's sort of like, that's like, this is the most pretentious thing in the world to say this, right? But that's the point. I get that that's the point. I understand that to a degree. Like, you're meant to have a bad time with this game. It is meant to just kick you in the nuts over and over again. You're not meant to be sitting here going, oh yeah, this is a fun experience. You're meant to be going, holy shit, I just need to get through this. You know what I mean? But it's like listening to like super abrasive music or whatever. Shit. It's that sort of concept. Something that's meant to invoke feelings other than, you know, accomplishment and enjoyment and hilarity and the stuff that you normally get from video games. It's instead like trying to turn that on its head. Or at least maybe I'm giving the developers too much credit. Maybe they're just shit at making games, you know, who knows? Who's to say? But yeah, it's meant to be a punishing, depressing, borderline offensive experience. And yeah, it kind of is one. You know what I mean? That is kind of what it is. Maybe I've been... Yes! Okay. Fucking did it. I did not realize I could actually do all that prior to... Yes! Give me all of this. Give me all of this now. Fucking beautiful. I need some health, man. I need a bed to lie in so I can recover my health. I need so many things. Can I just leave this place? Where even am I? Okay, drugs. Where's the nearest bed? I'm right near my place. Okay, cool. We'll head to there. See if I can make it before my health ticks away. Obviously, I'm going to have health problems. I'm going to have infection problems. Hunger problems. I meant not health problems. I'm going to have issues when I wake up, but the health is the biggest issue right now, and we need to get on top of that. You know what? I'll see you next time.